So hi friends, so I'll be giving the complete the inside information about and even the contributions of the great philosopher and the great king Krishnarajodayar four, that is he is well knownly called as Nalvadi Krishnarajodayar, and his tenure from 4 June to 1884 to 3 August 1940. So I'll be covering some important facts about the Krishnarajodayar, Nalvadi Krishnarajodayar, about his early years, that is childhood. And even I'll be discussing his service as a king to the society or the nation or even the world. And even what are the progress that has happened during his tenure as Maharaja, as well as his support towards the arts and cultural activities. And at the end, so what are all the titles and honors he has received for his contribution to the society. So let me begin with the introduction. So as I told, the Maharaja Krishnarajodayar IV, that is well knownly called as Nalvadi Krishnarajodayar. So he born on 4th June 1884 and he died on 3rd August 1940. So he was the 24th Maharaja of the Kingdom of Mysore from 1894. So when he became the Maharaja, until his death in 1940, nearly about 4 decades he served the nation as a Maharaja. And he was the firstborn son of the Maharaja Chamaraja Rajendra Odayar, is the 10th the Maharaja, and Maharani Vani Vilas Samidhana. So they were their his parents. And he was born, as I told, the June 4th, 1884 in the Mysore Palace itself. And coming to his early years, that is childhood. So his early education was under the guidance of P. Raghavendra Rao at the Lokaranjan Palace. So in Mysore, we have Lokaranjan Palace. So there is the education, it has started under his guidance. And the Yuraja was instructed in Western studies and even Kannada, the local language, as well as Sanskrit and Indian and Western classical music, as well as horse riding also. So he was instructed to learn. And Sir Stark Fraser of the Bombay Civil Service imparted administrative training to the young Maharaja. So this is an opportunity for young Maharaja to get the administrative training by him. And these studies were supplemented by extensive tours of Mysore, through which the Yuraja learned about the nature of the state he was to govern. So in fact, the Krishnarajodayar ascended the throne in 1895 at the age of 11 years after the death of his father. Okay, at the age of 11 year only, okay, he has taken the charge of the Maharaja. However, his mother was named state regent until 1902 because he was very young. On 6th June 1900, he married, about his marriage if we speak, on 6th June 1900, he married Maharani Pratapa Kumari Ambani of Kathiawar, the youngest daughter of Rana Sri Bane Singh Ji Sahib and Rana Sahib of Wana in the Kathiawar region of the present day. It is under Gujarat state. This is about his marriage. And if I speak about his service as a king, almost as I told, almost 4 decades he served as a king, and his service still, okay, we can remember him. So a lot of the service he has done to the society as well as the nation. Let me begin with the first one. The Krishnarajodayar took over the sovereign power of the Mysore state from his mother on February 8, 1902. And he was invested as the 24th Maharaja of Mysore by Viceroy Lord Curzon on August 8, 1902. at the Jagan Mohan Palace. Till now, the Jagan Mohan Palace is you can visit in Mysore. He ruled over the state for almost, as I told, 4 decades, that is 39 years, which were often described as a golden age of Mysore. Still we call this complete his tenure 39 years as the golden age of Mysore, because lot of the changes he brought and lot of this service he gave it to the nation during his tenure. And Gandhiji, Mahatma Gandhiji once remarked that Maharaja Krishnaraja Odayar, Nalvadi Krishnaraja Odayar, was the Rajashri of our nation. And even he was also compared to Emperor Ashoka by British nobility. Okay. So he was compared to the Emperor the Ashoka by the British nobility. This is also a very important fact. And so well recognized was his administration of the state that princes from other parts of India were sent to Mysore for their training. Because of his administrative skills, the princes of other the parts of the India, they used to send their Yuvarajas for the training purpose. And Maharaja Krishnaraja Odayar respected all the religions equally, and a number of temples, mosques and churches were built during his period. So this is also a very, very important fact. And during his 39 years as a Maharaja, the Krishnaraja Odayar had the following Diwan. That is, at that time, the Diwans are nothing but the prime ministers. Okay, so namely, there are 7 the Diwans have worked under his administration. So let me start from Sir P. N. Krishnamurti. So from 1901 to 1906, and Sri V. P. Madhav Rao from 1906 to 1909, and Sir T. Anand Rao from 1909 to 1912, and Sir M. Vishveshwaraya. So Sir M. Vishveshwaraya, he was one of the Diwans as Prime Minister under his administration from 1912 to 1919. So the most remarkable work which took place during Sir M. Vishveshwaraya as a Prime Minister or the Diwan of the Mysore Samsthana. And next to him, Sir M. Kantrajaras from 1919 to 1922. And next to him, Albion Rajkumar Banerjee from 1922 to 26. And the last Diwan, Sir Mirza Ismail, 1924 to 1941. So after his death, the next year, he retained actually. So next, coming to the progress during his tenure, what are the progressive work he has done under his tenure and all. So during the period of Krishnaraja Odayar IV, the Mysore kingdom comprising of Bangalore, Chitradurga, Hasan, Kadur, Kolar, Mysore, Mandya, Shivamogga and Tumkur saw an all-round development. So if I name one by one, so days together have to speak about it, but only the important, the remarkable changes that took place, I'll discuss now. So the first one is hydroelectric power project at Shivana Samudra, which started in the year 1902. So Mysore became the first state to produce the electric power, not only in India, but in the entire Asia. So this is the first remarkable work which is done by the Krishnaraja Odayar. In 1902, Mysore became the first state to produce the hydroelectric power. So not only India, but in the entire Asia. And next to it, Minto Eye Hospital. This is the world's oldest eye hospital. Still it exists. It was established during the Maharajas in 1903. Next, street lights in Bangalore. On the August 5th, 1905, street lights were introduced in Bangalore actually. This made Bangalore the first Asian city with street lights. So this is also just, you can make a note of it. This made the Bangalore the first Asian city with street lights. So the next one is bicameral assembly. So under the Krishna Raja Odia for the guidance, Mysore's representative assembly was expanded in 1907. The assembly became bicameral with the establishment of its legislative council. Next to that, women's right to vote. That is, long before women in America and other parts of the world were allowed to vote, they were given the right to do so in Mysore, first time in our country. Next, Vanivilas Sagar Dam in Chitradurga. So the dam was constructed in 1907, was the first dam in the entire Karnataka. Still it is exists. And Mysore Boy Scouts, this program introduced in 1909, was the first of its kind in India. And even, so the Indian Institute of Science, IISc, whatever what we call now, at Bangalore in 1911, that is 371 acres of land and funds were gifted to the Indian Institute of Science to begin running functionally. Still it is functioning, and this is the one of the oldest as well as the world renowned the institution which is recognized as the number one for the research and contribution to the society. And everyone know about the State Bank of Mysore. Recently it is merged with State Bank of India. So it is established in 1913 actually in Bengaluru. So Mysore Agricultural Residential School in Bengaluru, it is established in 1913 actually. And Kannada Sahitya Parishat, so in Bengaluru, it is established in 1915. Next, formation of Mysore Social Progress Association in 1915 to empower weaker section of society. And next to it, University of Mysore, this is the oldest university and internationally recognized university, established in 1916. And Bangalore Printing and Publishing Company, which is established in 1916. And Yuvaraja College in Mysore, established in 1916. And School of Engineering, Bangalore, later now we will call it as UVCE, established in 1917. And Mysore State Railway between 1916 and 1918, and which has opened 232 miles of railway to traffic by 1938 and 740 miles of railway track. Next, Mysore Chamber of Commerce, established in 1916. Next to it, the government sandalwood oil factory. Still it is the Mysore sandalwood factory. So it is established in Bangalore in 1916. And Maharani Science College for the Women, Mysore, still it has got its own name, established in 1917. Wood distillation factory, Bhadravati, in 1918. Next, Mysore Chrome and Training Factory, established in 1918. Appointment of Sir Leslie Miller in 1918 to look into problems of backward classes recommended. Reservation of 25% of jobs in government to non-Brahmins. That means reservation, the system started. And Lalit Mahal Palace in 1921. So now also you can visit Lalit Mahal Palace. Now it is converted to a five-star hotel. So still it has got its own, the beauty. Next year, Government Science College in Bangalore, in 1921 it is started. And Vishveshwara Iron and Steel Plant in Bhadravati was started as Mysore Iron Works in 1923. Next year, the first Indian state to enfranchise women in 1923. Next, KRS Dam, so all of us know about it. It's a world of a famous dam actually, Krishna Raja Sagar Dam. This dam was crucial to irrigation in Mysore and was built in 1924 after the Maharaja pledged his family assets to the project. At the time, it was Asia's the largest dam at that particular time. And even next to this, Mysore Medical College, it is called MMC in Mysore, established in 1924. Next, Krishna Raja Nagara was founded between 1925 and 1930 as a new town. After a flood by river Kaveri damaged the nearby town of Edattur actually. Next to it, in 1925, more than 100 acres of land was donated to the establishment of National Institute of Mental Health and Neurosciences. We still, it is existing in Bangalore. It is, we call it as NIMHANS actually. Establishment of Kadara Sahakara Sangha in 1925. Tagdur, which helped villages to earn livings. Next to it, Krishna Rajendra Hospital in Mysore, we'll call it as Care Hospital, Government Hospital, established in the year 1927, is attached to Mysore Medical College. Yes. So next to it, Care Market, Bangalore. So the main wholesale market dealing with commodities in Bengaluru, established in the year 1928. Next to it, Marakonahalli Dam in Tumkur district, completed in 1930. The dam has an automatic siphon system, first of its kind in the entire Asia. This is the speciality of this particular dam. And Mysore Sugar Mills in Mandya, established in 1933. And Care Mills, Mysore, established in 1933. And St. Philomela's Church, Mysore, so in 1933. It is also well renowned, the church actually. And Bangalore Town Hall in 1933, it is established. And Vanivilas Women and Children Hospital, Bangalore, which is established in 1934, named after Maharani Vanivilas Sannidhana, that is his mother. And Mysore Paper Mills in Bhadravati, established in the year 1936. Next to it, in 1934, the government of Mysore gifted 10 acres land in Bangalore to Nobel laureate Sri C.V. Raman for the creation of Research Institute, Raman Research Institute. And next, Mysore Lamps, Bangalore, established in 1936. And long back, it is closed. So Mysore Chemical and Fertilizers factory, so Belagola, established in 1937 actually. And next, Mysore Paints and Varnish Limited, established in 1934. And it became part of the public sector after 1947, after the independence. The government Dichromate factory in Belagola, it is started. Next, Maharani's College for Women, Bengaluru, established in 1938. It is also a well-known the institution, exclusively for girls. And next one is Glass and Porcelain Factories in Bangalore, established in 1939. And next, formation of Mandya District in the year 1939. Next, Mysore Implements Factory in Hassan, established in 1939 to produce agricultural and garden implements. And Hirey Baskara Dam started in 1939 across River Sharavati to ensure steady water supply for the 120 megawatt Krishna Rajendra Hydroelectric Power Station. The power station was renamed as Mahatma Gandhi Hydroelectric Project in the year 1949. Next, he became the first chancellor of the Banaras Hindu University in 1916. Even Banaras Hindu University is the oldest the university, still it has got its own name. Next, next to it, Irwin Canal, the later named as Vishwesharaya Canal, it has started but during his tenure only. And City Improvement Trust Board, first of its kind in India, it is started for the purpose of improvements. And banning child marriage, girls below age 8. So this is also one of the revolutionary, okay, the progress that he has done, banning the child marriage below the girl, the girls, girl child below the age of 8. And special importance for girl education and scholarship for widowed girl. So he has started. That's why in many in Mysore and Bangalore, you can see exclusive colleges and schools for girl students he has started. and alleviating poverty and improving rural infrastructure were his main concern. Okay, for the development of rural infrastructures and all, he worked a lot. And public health, education, and Mysore economy also flourished during his reign. And even in 1915, the Mysore Social Progress Association was formed to empower the weaker sections of the Mysore society, to help those weaker section, the people. So this particular society is formed. Next. In 1925, he also established the Kadara Sahakara Sangha to help villagers in the Tagadur. And the city, the Improvement Trust Board was set up under his guidance, the first association of its kind in India. And next to it, number of educational institutions were set up under his guidance, many of which are renowned even today. And the Sanskrit College in the Mysore was personally funded by the Maharajas. Still, we have this institution, okay, a Sanskrit Mahavidyalaya. So we have this. And primary education was made compulsory for everyone. And in 1915, and public schools were directed to begin admitting Dalit children in an effort to give up the caste discrimination. This is also revolutionary changes that he has brought, actually. So even right of education, what we call nowadays. So in 1915 only the Maharaja started this, and even for the Dalit children also. So that means so the discrimination concept, so he has removed. And then the Bangalore Agricultural University was also established in the year 1913. And even Kannada Sahitya Parishat was established in the year 1915. And Hindustan Aeronautics Limited, we call it as HAL now in Bengaluru, though the company came into existence much later, but the Maharaja laid its foundation stone in 1940 before its death. Today, Bangalore is known as the Silicon Valley of India, Silicon City, we call it. But this particular status was not achieved in a few years, but is the result of a foundation laid down by the erstwhile Maharaja of Mysore, that is none other than Nalvadi Krishna Raja Odayar. And he is supposed towards their hearts. That means Krishna Raja Odayar himself could play a number of musical instruments, including the violin, flute, sitar, veena, and saxophone, mridangam, piano, and nadaswaram. And even he, like his predecessors, he patronized a number of Hindustani, Carnatic, and Western artists. And even today, you can see during Dasara festival and all, so a lot of this musical concert will be hosted, even though now the entire the Dasara festival is done by the government people. Some of the esteemed guests of Maharaja of Mysore included Gawark Jan, Abdul Karim Khan, and members of the Agra Gharana, Ustad Vilayat Hussain Khan, and Natan Khan, and even Barkatullah Khan was the musician at the palace from 1919 to 1930. The Maharaja was also recognized for his promotion of Kannada and Sanskrit literature. I used to give a lot of talks in Kannada as well as in Sanskrit. And recognizing the many benefits of yoga, the Maharaja patronized Sri T. Krishnavacharya, who in turn trained Pattabhi Joyce and B.K. Iyengar. And coming to the titles and the honors which he has received for his tremendous the work and all, Yuvaraja Sri Krishna Raja Odayar Bahadur, Yuvaraja of Mysore, the year 1884 to 1894 he received, and Delhi Darbar Gold Medal he received in the year 1903. And His Highness Maharaja Sri Nalvadi Krishna Raja Odayar Bahadur, Maharaja of Mysore, 1894 to 1907, and Knight Grand Commander of the Order of the Star of India, GCSI, 1907. And His Highness Maharaja Sri Nalvadi Krishna Raja Odayar Bahadur, Maharaja of Mysore, GCST, once again, from 1907 to 1910. and Delhi Darbar gold medal in 1911 once again, and Bailiff Grand Cross of the Order of Saint John GCSTJ in 1911. So these are some of the awards given by the British government actually, and even Colonel is the Highness Maharaja Shri Sir Nalvadi Krishna Raja Odayar Bahadur Maharaja of Mysore GCSI from 1910 to 1917, and Knight Grand Cross of Order of British Empire GBE in the year 1917, King George V Silver Jubilee Medal in 1935, and King George VI Coronation Medal in 1937, and Colonel is Gaya Highness Maharaja Shri Nalvadi Krishna Raja Odayar Bahadur Maharaja of Mysore GCSI GBE from 1917 and 1940. Likewise, most of the awards he received by the British government, and honorary doctorate from Banaras Hindu University at its 21st convocation held on 28th of December 1937. So this role, some of this awards and titles he own. So here, what are all the details which I shared with you? It is only the important thing, but he has done a lot to the society during his tenure, and even to the entire nation he stand. So and it is recognized by the even today by the entire the globe or the world. And that's why, so this the contributions of this philosopher, the King Krishna Raja Odayar IV, and he is well knownly called as Nalvadi Krishna Raja Odayar, even though he ruled the entire Mysore Samsthana for 4 decades, about 39 years, okay, and he has born on 4th June 1884, and he died on 3rd August 1940. But during his tenure, the work which he has contributed to the nation or society, it is remarkable still, okay, so we remember him for his contribution to us. So thank you one and all. I hope the entire information which I have shared with you, so it is useful for you. Thank you.